how to use the APA template in the papers for this class. The first thing you're going to do is open up Microsoft Word. You can see that I'm using a Windows platform. So if you're using another platform with Office on it, you might see some variations in this. In addition, if you're using other language versions of Windows and Office, you might see some slight variations. However, these instructions are pretty robust against a lot of operating systems, so we should be pretty okay no matter what you're using. The first thing you do is you'll open Microsoft Word. I'd like you to take a look at the beginning of the styles in Microsoft Word. When you open Word, you're in the Home tab, and you have what are called quick styles. These are the specific things at the top of your document, and they'll vary based on how you use Word. We're going to go and we're going to open up the template, and I store the template in my documents. This is a fantastic template. It is based on work by Paul Rose out of Southern Illinois. And then it was modified by the University of North Carolina, their Department of Social Work. And then there's a substantial revision that I did for this class. Please make sure that you use the template that I developed for this class, because then we'll have the same types of heading instructions, instructions for your styles. Take a look at this. I've changed the styles now, and so everything that you need for this paper has an APA in front of it. That's your body text, the header, heading 2, heading 3, heading 4, and 5, neither of which you're likely to use in this paper. Then we've got something called the APA title. And the APA title only goes in two places. That's on the front page. So we make that an APA title. And then in APA papers, we don't use the word introduction. We repeat the title again, and that gets an APA title format. That's your very first step. The next step is to come in and write a running header. And it's a short version of your title, all in characters, all in capitalized characters. And so for this one, you double click to open up what's called the header. And I'm going to title my paper look at me go, the no all caps rule there. Deception in instructional videos. Then we're going to tab this over so that the number 1 is on the top far right. So then we're done with it, and we can see that on each successive page we have an increment in page number and the same running title. As soon as you're done with that step, go ahead and file, save as, and rename it as number 1, a Word document instead of a template. And we're going to call this exactly like the running header, Deception in Instructional Videos. And give a date for when you started on this version. My suggestion is that with each successive version that you write on the new day, you go ahead and save it by the new day, keeping the same running header. That way, if anything happens to a version of your paper, you'll have previous versions ready to go. That's everything you need to know about starting your APA paper. At the end of this template is something extremely handy. It has a set of guidelines in here for different types of common references. I highly recommend it. It is not going to be as good as an APA reference manual, but it will help you out with certain types of formats. that for certain types of references. That's the end of step one, how to save your paper.